द विंग्स ऑफ द डव बाय हेनरी जेम्स कैरेक्टर्स थीम्स समरी एंड एनालिसिस। हेलो एंड वेलकम टू द डिस्कोर्स। वी आर डिस्कसिंग द साइकोलॉजिकल नॉवल्स बाय हेनरी जेम्स। द विंग्स ऑफ द डव वॉज पब्लिश्ड इन 1902 एंड इट इज कंसिडर्ड वन ऑफ द बेस्ट नॉवल्स बाय हेनरी जेम्स। इन 1998 मॉडर्न लाइब्रेरी रैंक्ड द विंग्स ऑफ द डव 26th ऑन इट्स लिस्ट ऑफ द 100 बेस्ट इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज नॉवल्स of the 20th century. This novel is an effective transition between the romantic literature of the 19th century and the psychologically oriented literature of the 20th century. There are some similarities in the story of the Wings of the Dove and Henry James' previous novel, The Portrait of a Lady. Both of these novels depicts a rich young woman being deceived by one of her friend and a man with whom she falls in love. The character of Millie Thiel in this novel was inspired and based on Minnie Temple, a real cousin of Henry James, who died of tuberculosis at the age of 25. Henry mentioned in an interview that he always had the intention of writing a story about Minnie Temple to wrap and preserve her memories in the beauty and dignity of art. Characters of the Wings of the Dove. Kate Croy is an ambitious young girl of London whose father is a poor, never-do-well man. She is being taken care of by her aunt, Mrs. Lauder. Merton Densher is a young reporter whom Kate loves and wants to marry, but Mrs. Maud Lauder doesn't approve of him. Millie Thiel is a young rich American girl who is suffering some strange illness that the doctors couldn't recognize or cure. Sir Luke Strett is a physician who tries to cure Millie. Mrs. Stringham is an old friend of Maud Lauder and the traveling companion of Millie Thiel. Millie arrives to London along with Mrs. Stringham. Lord Mark is a former suitor of Kate Croy, whom Kate rejected. Themes of the Wings of the Dove. Henry James continued on his theme of depicting differences between American life, which is morally strong and loud, and European life, which appears more cultured but is ruined and debauched. Henry depicts Millie Thiel as a rich American heiress with truthful heart and love for life. Kate Croy and Merton Densher are British. While Kate is depicted as a greedy, conniving and conspiring woman, Densher still has got a sense of morality, honesty, faithfulness and guilt. The major themes of the novel are love, betrayal, faithfulness and guilt. The major conflict is of moral character rather than of cultural background. The novel continues to describe the psychological dynamics of its characters and the nuances of various relationships of characters with one another. Summary of the Wings of the Dove. Kate Croy is living with her maternal aunt, Mrs. Maud Lauder, in London, who doesn't like her poor never-do-good father and doesn't want Kate to do similar mistake that her mother did, to marry a wrong person. Aunt Lauder is a rich, dominating yet very caring woman. Kate Croy is in relationship with a young, struggling journalist, Merton Densher. They secretly marry as Kate knows her aunt will never accept Merton as her husband because he is poor and doesn't earn much. They haven't yet consummated their marriage as they are not sure how to convince Mrs. Lauder. Kate also realizes that she cannot afford to ruin her relationship with Mrs. Lauder as she is the only source of wealth for her. One day, one of Mrs. Lauder's old friend, Mrs. Stringham, arrives at Mrs. Lauder's house, along with a young, beautiful, rich American heiress whose name is Millie Thiel. Millie is an orphan with no family, but she owns considerable wealth. Mrs. Stringham is her traveling partner. Kate is very impressed by Millie and she soon befriends her. The two girls enjoy sightseeing in London, and as Kate gains trust of Millie, Millie reveals to her that she thinks she is suffering from some strange disease and she needs to meet a doctor. Kate took her to Sir Luke Strett, who is a renowned doctor. Luke Strett examines Millie but couldn't ascertain of her disease. Yet he is convinced that her health is deteriorating. Kate realizes that Millie is suffering some unknown disease and it would be difficult for her to live long. She immediately devises a plan that could solve her problems. She thinks that if Merton marries Millie, he will become the heir of her wealth, and as Millie is ill and will die soon, he will become rich. Kate thinks that as Merton will become rich, her aunt, Mrs. Lauder, will accept their marriage. Merton had gone to a trip to America as a journalist, and in America, he had already met Millie once. Millie unknowingly started liking and desiring Merton, though she never revealed her feelings to anyone. Soon, Merton returns from America and Kate begins to try bringing Merton and Millie closer to each other. On the other hand, Aunt Maud also wants Millie and Merton to be together, as she realizes that Merton is poor but a good, honest boy. Since Millie has enough money, if Millie marries Merton, Aunt Lauder thinks then it will be beneficial for both Millie and Merton. She also thinks that if Merton married Millie, then it will make sure that Kate won't fall for Merton. So when she observes that Kate is trying to bring Merton and Millie closer, she also helps, as she is unaware of the conspiracy of Kate, and she also doesn't know that Kate is already engaged to Merton. They already married secretly. Aunt Lord plans for a leisure visit to Venice along with Mrs. Stingham and takes Kate and Millie with her. Kate designs her plan and calls Merton to follow her to Venice. In Venice, Millie arranges for a grand party in a Venetian palazzo. Merton also reaches there and attends the party. During the party, Kate reveals her plan to Merton and insists him to lure Millie and marry her. She tells him about the illness of Millie and says that soon she will die and then Merton will inherit her property, and as he will be rich, then Aunt Lord will allow Kate to marry him. Merton is reluctant and is feeling guilty about all this. He truly loves Kate and doesn't want to deceive Millie, but he succumbs to the pressure of Kate as he has no other choice. However, he puts forth a condition and tells Kate that he will agree to her plan only if she consummates their marriage with him. Kate gives up and both of them spend a night together, consummating their marriage and taking it to the final course. Kate then makes Aunt Lord to return to London along with her, while Merton remains in Venice for some pretended official job along with Millie. Millie is already infatuated with Merton since she met him in America, and now when Merton deliberately tries to win her heart, she soon falls deeply in love with Merton. Merton proposes her and she agrees, but before they could marry, a former suitor of Kate, Lord Mark, accidentally meets Millie. Millie reveals him that she is planning to marry Merton. Lord Mark was rejected by Kate as she already married Merton secretly, and Lord Mark knew it. So he tells Millie that Merton is in relationship with Kate as the two married secretly. Knowing this, Millie feels a sudden heartbreak. She realizes that the evil plan of Kate and Merton. She confronts Merton and asks him the truth. Merton was already uncomfortable with this deception. He is guilt-ridden and confesses his sin to Millie. Millie tells him to go away and the plan of their marriage goes to in ruins. The heartbreak weakens Millie further and she suffers sudden fall of health and dies. Merton comes back to London and he comes to know that before dying, Millie made him and Kate her equal heir and they have got the equal portions of all her property after her death. Kate is happy as she feels that now she can easily win Aunt Lauder's nod for her marriage with Merton. However, Merton is guilt-ridden. He confronts Kate and tells her that he will live with her only if she agrees to give up all the money of Millie she has got to some charity, as he will do the same. Otherwise, he will leave Kate and in return, he will also give his share of Millie's property to Kate. Kate misunderstands the guilt feeling of Merton as his love for Millie and decides to take the money while leaving Merton. In the end, the love pair part their ways and Kate tells to Merton, "We shall never be again as we were." The novel ends with this cryptic notion. We can compare the character of Madame Merle of the Portrait of a Lady with Kate Croy. Both of these characters falls from their moral grounds and disrespect conventional relationships. Isabel Archer of Portrait of a Lady is not very comparable with Millie because Isabel is a character full of life, moral strength and a sense of individual liberty who ultimately decides to respect the conventional relationships on her own accord. Also, despite similarities between Merton and Gilbert Osmond of Portrait of a Lady, there is a stark difference. Unlike Osmond, Merton is not snobbish nor he is greedy. He still has maintained a moral scale and feels guilty of the wrong he commits against Millie, a dying girl. Ultimately, he rejects all the money he won as a result of that deception, and he rejects Kate too, who actually conspired the plan of deception. So this was all about The Wings of the Dove. We will come back again with another important work of Henry James. Please stay connected with the discourse. Thanks and regards.